Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind, brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon. As per usual, we're going to get right in here, and the first thing I want to do, because otherwise I'm going to forget, is we're going back to Ebonheart, because Ragefast mentioned that when we rescued that Khajiit, there was an Argonian in yellow robes in there, and apparently, if we'd have talked with them, they would have given us a bit of a reward. So naturally, we are going to go back and get our reward. Dang it. Because, I mean, honestly, I didn't really do that quest to get a reward, but I'm not gonna complain. It was also mentioned to me by Crimson Cavalier that
I will listen, Outlander.
A good way to train your... mercantile skill in this is apparently when you make an offer to an NPC, and I actually didn't notice this, when you make an offer to an NPC shopkeeper when you're trading with them, if they refuse it, you can continue making the offer and they will eventually accept so long as it's within like a certain threshold. So basically you just hammer on offer until they either pay you or they hate you a lot. And once they hate you a lot, their disposition drops a little bit every time you fail to make a deal with them. You just leave conversation with them and return to the conversation, and apparently it resets their disposition. So that's good to know, and that's probably going to help in kind of training up my mercantile a little bit. All right, so here is the
approaches.
The Argonian. So let's ask about Rabina.
It is good that you brought her here. We have heard tales of drugs being smuggled inside these poor people. Or sometimes there seems to be no lull the smugglers and slavers won't stoop to for profit. We will give her the help she needs. Thank you, and please take this in return. Perhaps it will help you in funding other missions of goodwill. Take care.
Wow, 400 gold. Nice. I will take it. I will take it. I think that gives us like a whopping total of 400 gold. Probably a little bit more than that. 921. That is acceptable. And I always get lost in this place. I always beeline straight ahead for whatever reason. Jesus Christ. Everybody's saying yes. They're saying yes in stereo. It's terrifying. Anyways, now we are going to go back to the Vec and probably putter around a little bit. I think I might start working on the Fighters Guild quests again. Just to kinda, oh God, kinda get along with that.
Let's see,
go ahead and travel to the Vec. It was also mentioned to me by Ragefast that, God, how long does this boat trip take? It's like day, night, day, night, day, night. Where even is Ebonhold? To bring up the map. It doesn't bring up the map, Gene. Oh, okay, so Ebonheart's actually quite a ways down there. Good to know. All right, that's further down southward than I thought it was. All right. But anyways, Ragefast mentioned that there's a quest in the Mage's Guild that actually causes that enchantress that I keep trying to steal from to walk away from her desk for a while. So that's probably something we will get to eventually. But
just for you.
I'm not in too big a hurry to be stealing her soul gems from her. It's just something that I kind of have been doing passingly to entertain myself. Okay, so if I recall correctly, we actually have a quest from the Fighter's Guild. Fighters Guild, Telvanni agents. Yes, kill 4 Telvanni agents responsible for thefts and disappearances at the Caldera Mine. Alright, they're hiding in the cave hills north of... They're hiding in a cave in the hills north of Caldera Mine. And they probably have a lookout posted. Alright, so we have to find the Caldera... I did it again! We have to find the Caldera Mine. Which, if I recall correctly... Alright, so we've been there. Is this the Caldera Mine? No, that is the Shulk Egg Mine. Alright. Well, in that case, I have absolutely no idea where the Caldera Mine is. Maybe we should ask our guild leader about that, and maybe they'll tell us. Would be nice. Still can't get over how much nicer this game looks with all these texture mods and stuff. It's crazy. The stuttering still drives me nuts, though. Freaking cells loading and stuff. You are not who I want. You are who I want. Can you tell me about the Caldera? Everybody minds, they're southwest of the town of Caldera, I believe. All right. Can you, if I ask you enough, will you put it on my map? No. Check around when you're in Caldera. They'll give you better directions. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, I don't suppose I'm ready for advancement, am I? Yay, we are now the apprentice. Am I ready for more advancement? And I'm a journeyman.
Oh.
I'm a journeyman, bitches! Teach me things. What do you got? Heavy armor, blunt weapons, armor. Gosh. Too expensive. Too rich for my tastes. However, see, an iron claymore. We can't take any of the magic stuff. Iron tanto. Throwing knives. Now, you don't have anything I care about. And I don't think I have anything you care about either, except for this. 3 gold. You can keep refusing, man. You're gonna pay it eventually. Or not. Alright, fine. 2 gold. Yeah, as you can see, his disposition is now 13, but I believe if we leave and talk to him again, it's back up to 58.
You've got my ear.
Because game logic! It just works like that. What do you do? What do you train in? Medium armor, long blade, and block. Really? Block training is actually kind of tempting. Because block is otherwise kind of a pain in the ass to train. Just pay my way to the next level. Go full pro like that. But I don't think we're gonna do that. And if I recall correctly, there's nothing. Yeah, you guys don't have anything. This is silver, isn't it? Yeah. Can I? I don't know if it's stealing. Let's find out. Nope. Better they didn't see me. Fighters Guild Charter. Chitin Spear, Iron Spear, whatever. Man, it's not an iron sword. It's worthless to me. Got my saber. Who needs a spear when you've got a saber? Alright, so we've got to get to Caldera then. And I just about hit M to bring up my map again. Which I believe, yes, is to the north. Which means hiking! Which means I am going to be editing this down. Unless I forget, in which case you guys are going to be treated to a couple minutes of silence as I just run there. So I will see you guys in Caldera. I will either see you guys in Caldera, or I will see you on the road to Caldera if something interesting pops up. So until then. Okay, and we are at Caldera now. So yeah, hopefully that trip wasn't too bad. I'll probably speed that up to be about, I don't know, maybe 10 seconds worth of walking instead of what looks to have been about 2 minutes worth. Just be a bit quicker that way. Hey there, friendo. Why don't you tell me where the ebony mines are? They're southwest of the village of Caldera. There's an office, a bunkhouse, and a guard tower over near the mine entrance. Thinking of taking a look while you're here, head straight west from town, then swing around south into the bowl of the mine through a gap in the mountains. Otherwise, you can try climbing straight over the ridge, but it's too steep for most. Alright, southwest of the village. Noted. Which is this way. Part of me thinks we might have already been there. I seem to recall being in an ebony mine at least once. No, I'm certain we were in an ebony mine. I don't know if it was this one, though, because we couldn't carry all of our loot out with us. I'm gonna guess it's not this one on account of I have mapped none of this area. So. And they say this is steep for most, huh? Most people haven't been navigating Oblivion Mountain since they were, I don't know, young. Oblivion was what, 2004? I think, was it 2004? Thereabouts? I think it was 2004. Yeah, so I've been navigating Elder Scrolls Mountains for a while now. Okay, here's what we're looking for, I assume. I'm a quick save because this is gonna turn to violence. I am absolutely positive. And we're just gonna walk in. Oh, that looks like a lookout right there. Well, I'm gonna let my stamina go ahead and recharge itself. And part of me wants to just open this up with death magic. We're gonna quick save, even though I think I probably already did. You the lookout? Are you gonna do this violent like? Am I gonna electrocute the shit out of your ass? I don't know you, what do you want? Well, you offer me training, so maybe you're not the lookout. Marksman sneak and block. Huh. Let's see here. Telvanni agents?
Aw, oh, this is too easy.
No, I haven't seen any Telvanni agents around here, although now that you mention it. Oh, you do ranged combat too? Sure, we'll play. Alright, ow. I'm out. Now you die. And that armor he's rocking is actually protecting him pretty well. Less so from that. All right. I figured he was going to attack me, so... I mean, I should have just opened up on him from the range, but whatever. Well, this is worth 230, so we're gonna take that. God, I am so encumbered. I forgot to drop off all my crap at my house. Damn it. We have a ton of arrows, so I don't exactly need more. Longbow, that is markedly better than my crappy little chitin one. Some restore health potions, the bargain brand. That's what you get for buying Sam's Club, dude. You fucking get shanked by some asshole throwing death magic at you. Let me see here. First thing I wanna do is come in here and inventory. I think I just hit take all on him on accident there instead of close because we have a bunch of random garbage in our inventory now. Sorry, dude, I didn't mean to completely strip you. But I did. Let's see here. Where is the queer ass? Because that thing's gonna be... Well, maybe I didn't... Did I not take... I didn't take all of this stuff. I was just carrying a bunch of random trash on me for reasons. Whatever. I don't know. All right, now there's a small stack of random things laying there for some confused person to stumble upon. All right, so how many of these guys were in here? There were, I think, four. Quests, Bounty Fighters Guild. Fighting Kill 4, yes. Alright. All you, Arlan. I think we just killed Arlan. One. So, Arlan, Narothen, Harothran, and Alvaleg. I actually think we just killed Alvaleg. We just killed Alvaleg? Yeah, we just killed Alvaleg. Alright, so there's three more of them in here, and I'm saving for probably like the fourth time. But I fear everything. I don't like how dark it is in here. Where is it? Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh, that was well aimed. I see you. I see you bastards. Here, come on. Oh, you don't even have armor on. Oh, but one of you has a magic sword. Oh, who's got it? It's you, isn't it? Oh, you fiends. All right, gotta drink potions. I'm gonna drink a fire shield. I'm gonna drink... Where are those bargain healing potions? There's 50 hit points. That'll actually fully heal over time. Bam, click to victory. My heavy armor is increasing. Oh, I think the one in back is a mage. That's what's doing it, okay. I want fortify health, I want restore health. Oh wow, these are 1 point per second. Ugh, less amazing. I'm gonna run away now. Oh no, I'm stuck on the terrain. I don't know where I'm even going here. Oh, where's the entrance? There's the entrance, woo! I don't believe they'll follow me outside. I don't think the AI was that good at this point. Okay, well these guys are just not playing around. Let's see, what is, okay, so chopping is actually my best attack with this, good to know. I want a lantern. So that I can see these assholes before I kill them. Hey, you dicks. I'm just gonna sit here and click until you die. If you don't have armor on. Well, play with magic, huh? Have some magic of mine.
You will suffer greatly.
Hearth heal. Ha ha! Full hit points. Because for some reason that healing spell is really good. Alright. Throw in all your death magic. Well, I got it too, huh? How's it feel? Not so much fun, is it? Oh, she's got some healing spells going on too. Heal through an axe, well, sword to the face. Yeah. Smote in heroistic fashion. I don't know. Some cheap restore health potions, nice. A scroll of summon skeleton, acceptable. You have, Jesus, just a lot of potions on these guys. Fortify speed, restore fatigue. Some leathers. Iron shards, so there's the cold damage. I knew one of them freaking had a magic weapon on him. Thought it was the mage there towards the end, but it was not. Okay, does that thing seriously weigh 20 pounds? That thing seriously weighs 20 pounds for a one-handed sword. Jesus Christ, you guys, like, damn, what is it with game developers and not knowing how much weapons weigh? Like, a freaking Scottish claymore weighed 6 pounds. Come on, guys. That is, I'm gonna leave this thing behind. It's worth 60. That is not worth what it's gonna cost me to carry that damn thing. Let's see, what else can I ditch? Any particularly heavy alchemy ingredients? The freaking alembics and stuff. Not looking like it. Well, damn. Here we go. We'll drop this torch. There. Uh-oh. Where'd my light go? There we go. All right, well, we took care of those D-bags. In good time, too. So I'm going to go ahead and rest. I didn't necessarily mean to rest that long. Oh no! Our sleep has been interrupted by the most dangerous creature of all, a scrib. Solve that problem. Okay, so now we are going to waddle our happy ass back to Balmora. And I'm gonna turn this in, and I wanna say, probably call it an episode. Not because we're gonna be over time, but because I'm thinking that this is probably actually a good stopping point. So I will see you guys back in Balmora for the quest turn in, and maybe we'll even get promoted. So I will see you in a moment. Okay, and we are back in Balmora. So let us go turn this in. Speak, traveler. Everybody's telling me to speak, and I don't want to. What is this, Operation Mindcrime? Oh, that's a reference. 5 points if you get that one. Okay, so let's turn this sucker in. Hello, they're dead. You got all four, good. That'll make some people at Caldera Mining Company very happy. Here's 400 septums. The mining company pays well, and when you're ready for more orders, let me know. Can I advance? Yes! No! Perform more duties, that's okay. So what's next? I need someone to return a code book that belongs to our client. Alright. The code book our client wants is in the hands of Sotild at the South Wall in Balmora. Find that code book and bring it back to me. Alright, who's Sotild? She's Thieves Guild. I take full responsibility, and listen, I'm Guild Steward. When I say jump and you ask how high, keep that in mind, and we won't have any problems. Okay. Actually, tell me about this code book. Code book our client wants is in the hands of Sotild. Alright. Anyways, we're gonna call it here. So, after all editing, it should be roughly 20 minutes. A little short, I think, but whatever. I am going to off screen. Shut up, woman. Between this episode and next week's recordings, I am going to actually clear out my house. I'm also going to sell off a bunch of the random crap we're carrying. Just to kind of save some screen time for that. So, as per usual, thank you for watching, and I hope to catch you all next time. We're in more Fighters Guild stuff. I will be doing the quests you guys have suggested. Believe me, I will. I'm just getting some stuff out of the way early here. So, until then.